Back live to Hotheads, where activism happens. That was, what was it, Jimi
Hendrix. Yeah. Come on, Jimmy.
Of course, I just, you know, it's waiting. We're working together. You can finish my words.
Okay. Yeah. It's been a minute, so we have to get back in the flow.
I know. It has. Yeah, we've been going, because we missed the Freedom Rally last week.
Yep.
It's like, yeah, thank God we're back.
We're here.
Yeah. She's fuller.
It does. It does.
And last week was a big, crazy show.
Yeah.
It was awesome. I mean, we had Jody Emery on there. I almost started crying with Jody at the end. It was just that kind of moment towards the end of the show. We had Dave Crespo here.
Awesome.
It was a great show, but
You guys did end the Fed,
yeah.
And I heard all about it from Garrett Kirkland. We're going to talk about that a little bit more later, but I heard it was a huge success.
It was. It was a tough show, though, at the same time, because I had no voice, because I audit the Fed. You know, so I'm doing
a show. That's a good reason to not have a voice, though.
It was a great show. And this week, we're trying to do the same thing. We're going to try to get as many people as we can, as we always do on the show. And right now, we have Danny in the studio.
Yeah.
Very happy about
that. The lovely Danny
to
my left
Dan.
Over here.
Aww, thanks, guys.
You're classing up the place right now, Danny. I hope you know.
And that's a good thing.
And that's a great thing. Yeah.
We met you at the Freedom Rally. Yep. You were in a little video at our booth. She came by our Two Hotheads Where Activism Happens booth. And we talked briefly and talked about your book. Tell us about the book and how you got where you are. Because you don't look like what most people would think of as the typical pot smoker or pot supporter. Marijuana, you know.
What's that supposed to be?
What is that? Maybe I'm being stereotypical, but, you know, that someone that would be having a book, you know, titled what it is. So tell us about how you got where you are.
Yep.
It started when my friend Lindsay and I were smoking, and we came up with this great idea about how we should write a comic book about these two women who save the world by smoking weed. Like, that's their, like, superpowers is when they smoke weed. So she ended up being super busy. So
that's awesome, by the way. That's excellent.
So she couldn't do it because she was, like, super busy. And so I asked my sister, who has a writing background. But my sister's never smoked weed before in her life. And so when she was, like, drawing everything, she had to, like, look up what a bowl looked like. She had to look up what a joint looked like. And yeah, so I just, like, wrote it and just rewrote it, and I had a lot of, like, help from family and friends who would, like, reread it and help me make corrections and stuff.
That's awesome that you get that much support. Hey, Mom and Dad, I'm writing a comic book on weed. Can you proofread it for me? That's pretty badass.
My mom likes to, like, throw in every now and then, like, I don't agree with it, but I'll support you anyways.
I heard that a lot from my mom, actually.
Yeah, isn't that a common place to get? And that's something for to help out people maybe who haven't gotten there with their parents. That is what you're going to end up getting, you know, like generally in a lot of cases. You know, you can never win the argument. You just accept what it is, right?
Yeah, my mom's great like that.
Yeah, that's a good place to be.
Yeah.
So what kind of superpowers do you get? I mean, I know what kind of superpowers I get when I'm high, but what is represented in the comic book?
So let's say you're having a heart attack and they have to smoke in order to save you, or else they wouldn't know what to do.
Well, that means you should be high before they have a heart attack.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you can't even have time to save someone. Like, oh, I'm going to take a smoke break while this guy's dying of a heart attack. That means you got to be stoned 24/7, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I'm with that then. That's the way I'm trying to be. Like, I get more shit done if I got my weed. Like, I don't need it. If I don't have it, sometimes it's fine not to be stoned and I feel great. Like, I don't need to have weed. But it's true. It's
added,
like,
bonus.
It is
that's what
added
I
bonus.
Experienced,
it's like,
actually,
I feel like I have more superpowers in some ways.
I was going to say, I experienced that this past weekend when I was gone from the show. I was out hiking in the mountains, and it was pretty intense, and we were there on, like, a company training and stuff, so it was, like, camping and hiking, and I couldn't sleep because I was so stressed out, and I was, like, you know, I didn't think that I was going to be able to do it, and I found, like, the one other dude on the trip. He's like, yo, you smoke? I'm like, oh, fuck yeah.
Yo, fuck yeah.
And then, like, that second night, we got high, and then by the next day when I was scaling that mountain, I was like, I got this. This is great. I went straight to sleep the night before. I mean, it was perfect. That's like, you know, and that brings together the marijuana is medicine argument that we're working on here. That, you know, obviously it should be legal for everyone. Because even if I don't have a specific medical need, yo, the fact that, like, solved all my problems.
Oh, dude. You know? And it's like, I got to tell you.
I felt like a superhero. You know?
This
like,
whole thing about where I bring up about being an athlete in the past.
Yeah.
And still an athlete.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so many. We talked to Toby Greer, and he's got access to all these other professional martial artists that he works with. He's one of the top. The guy's an amazing. He trains warriors, and they use marijuana. Like Eddie mm-hmm. Bravo, they use marijuana. Yep. Joe Rogan.
Yep.
You know, these guys are using cannabis as athletes for a reason. There is
or
nothing.
Like that woman Arnold who got disqualified from the Olympics.
Yeah,
that
Arnold,
was the
yeah.
that was the
wrestler.
Female? No, the female weightlifter.
Well, there's a female wrestler.
Oh, wait. Oh yeah, wrestler. You're right.
This year.
Yep.
There's been too many.
That was considered performance enhancing.
Yeah, and also,
I might agree.
Also another gentleman from this area who was in judo. You know, I mean,
yep.
It's like these guys. We're totally getting off the track a little bit because we're getting so much into so many different topics as
but
we
that
do.
Just made me think. Like, isn't it contradictory to say like marijuana is a performance enhancing drug, but it'll ruin your life?
I know.
Isn't that kind of ridiculous?
I know.
Sorry, I'm just.
And it's not even a. It's not. Let's not call it a drug. Let's call it a performance enhancing herb.
Yeah, exactly.
Because that's kind of what it is.
Tea.
It's like a it's like tea.
Like
tea.
Oregano.
Tea does help you as an athlete,
I
would say. You know, like these are little edges that people get, and I would call them superpowers in some ways for some of us, not all people. Some people do have issues with cannabis; they can't handle it. Their body chemistry, whatever it is. Some people cannot handle cannabis.
And we respect that, too.
Yeah. But some of us are getting superpowers. I know that for a fact.
So you can resuscitate people, using your marijuana superpowers, right? If they're having a heart attack or something, what else can you do?
Yeah.
It depends on what the issue is. If you have to get a cat out of the tree, like a joint, joint would probably be okay. But like if you're trying...
A joint.
But if you like have to save the world, like the world's like crumbling before you, like you probably would want to use a vaporizer.
A Vapor Brothers vaporizer.
Is there a certain kind of herb that you use, like certain strains, or just like you look for certain things?
That's
so gotta be
funny.
Good stuff or
Oh no, I actually haven't thought about that. That would be really good to introduce another.
I'm right.
So who are the enemies? Who are the enemies? Do you ever fight villains and stuff? Usually superheroes are the heroes, you know, superhero stories have the villains as well.
Yeah, like the government wants to shut them down. They want to like use them for like experiments and stuff.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So why
doing COINTELPRO? Is there any COINTELPRO going yet?
No, not yet.
Oh, that's another storyline. I'll tell you all about it. I know about it.
Yeah, that's pretty hilarious, actually. So do you have like a character like the man? And he comes in and they're like, no, fuck you.
Not yet. No.
Well, we're writing. We're
how many issues do you have of this?
We just have one. I've written the second one. And then
I want to help you with this.
Yeah.
Okay.
I actually am really, my friends and I did a, well, I actually didn't do this. I'm totally like attaching myself to their memory. But they did a 24-hour comic where they wrote a comic for 24 hours and like created it, and it's really fucking cool. Awesome. I read like Adventure Time, which are totally stoner superhero comics, and like I don't know, I think there needs to be more, especially females writing comics and illustrating them and creating them, and then it's about weed.
I want to know if I can be in it.
I kind of
can there
you.
Be a Mike Tan and it's like I'm just a character in there.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Write us in Heather Mack.
The two hotheads could be like
we want to be in that.
Yes.
Like I will support it. I'll promote it. I'll get sponsors for it. Like that's what we.
What would your weed superpower be?
I want to have an ebook too. Like tell us about ebook. Well, what would my superhero?
What
It'd
would
be
your
Mike
weed
Tan.
No. What would your weed superpower be?
You know me, fire. I'm fucking. I'm
fire.
All about truth and fire, like truth and justice and bringing
so
it down.
So you spit fire, you'd like straight up
something
spit
like
fire.
That. You know, you figure, you know, I mean, I would just be me though. You know, I just, I don't know. They'd have to figure that out later. I don't want to get all into me.
I'm trying to think of what mine would be.
Yeah, what would yours be?
Well, I would want to spit
you'd just
fire
be,
too. You
no,
know?
You'd be spitting sound spit and show. Like, you got that hip hop thing going. You've got to have
that's
something to
I'm
do
saying.
With that. Yeah.
I don't know. I'll work on it.
You'll
lose
fire, but
we'll
it's got to be.
We'll work on our characters for this. I think we have a partnership right now. Am I right?
Yeah.
We got
You're
this.
Right. Yeah.
So, okay, your question, ebooks.
Ebooks. Tell us, like, How do people get on there? How does that work? How hard is it? How much does it cost? What's the what's the return for people? Because I think there are a lot of old and new activists that take advantage of things like YouTube and to build a brand, but they're still missing ebooks. Like for myself, I know I should have something on there. Like what advice do you give people about ebooks and how it works?
I'm still kind of figuring that out, but it's a great way to self-publish yourself. I know probably a lot of people who are trying to publish books about marijuana are having a hard time getting it published because it's such like still a taboo subject. So ebooks is a great way to self-publish it. And it's a lot cheaper way than to print books out. And right now we're not printing out actual comic books because it would just be too expensive. And there's not as much attention that where if we were to like print them out, we'd make money. So right now it's just like a project that we're doing, and we're funding it ourselves, and it's just something that we really want to do. But there's definitely like ways to get money to help yourself self-publish. We tried something called Kickstarter.com where people would donate money to you, but that didn't work out. And I wish I had known about something called Indiegogo.
Oh yeah.
Which is like on the same lines, but Kickstarter, you have to have like an amount, like let's say $1,000. And if you don't reach $1,000, you don't get any of the money.
Yeah, it's all or none.
That's yeah.
Crazy. Which makes it like, it's funny, the two, Kickstarter is the one that brings in all the real money, like the major money. Amanda Palmer got over $1 million on there. And that's why, because it's so exciting. People want you to make that goal, but it still sucks.
And then she got a lot of backlash.
It still sucks, and it puts out so much stress on the person putting out the deal, because if you don't get that
There's no accountability to it either. I mean, honestly, once you come through it, it's like, do you actually have to produce something? Are people... Like,
well, that too, but I think it's a good thing.
I do too.
I think people generally, the artist or the person putting out the deal, wants to own up to it because they're trying to please people who just gave them money for the most part. So I think it's a great platform. It just, I think that stress.
Yeah.
If you don't, like, I've thought about doing a Kickstarter for all the stuff that we do, but it's that stress of how much do we really need, and how much. Like, what if we don't make the goal? Because it's so stressful. It's you're literally begging your friends to give money so you make the goal.
I know, like, Indiegogo, you don't have to. It's not all or nothing. Like, whatever anyone chooses to, like, donate to you.
Yep.
So.
I wish Indiegogo was more popular than Kickstarter.
Can we donate to your Indiegogo? Do you still have an account up there?
No, we don't. We never started an Indiegogo account.
Yeah, maybe next time.
Yeah, you should.
But that's the issue that we all have right now. Like, Kickstarter is the platform. Indiegogo is almost the same thing, but it's way not popular. It's not as popular. People aren't raising as much money. You put the same two projects on Kickstarter, you're going to raise more money.
Yeah.
So that's, you know, that's the issue people have. That their platform is actually the right way because it keeps it exciting. People like stakes, you know, unfortunately. But Two Hot Heads, Where Activism Happens. Where can people buy this? Tell us more about where people can buy the book. And do you have like a website? Like, how do people find you online besides the book?
Yeah, you can find us on Facebook. If you type in the Super Highs, we have a Tumblr. I think it's tumblr.superhighs.
Oh, yes.
And then if you want to search Amazon Kindle for the Super Highs, you can type Danny Marie in or Jessica Vitale. It will like come up, and I believe it's $1.99, and I think it's about 30 pages, and it's awesome.
Cool.
Yeah. It's also on a website called graphically.com, which was a website we tried out and said that it would, because it's expensive to like put it out on Amazon because it's like you need USB numbers and whatnot. And they kind of advertised that they could do it for you. And it actually hasn't really come to fruition. Like, I don't recommend using graphically.com, but we definitely have one on graphically.com. And so you can also buy it there if you don't have a Kindle.
Now, I just think it's so impressive because, you know, there's quite a lot of stoners, myself included, who will say like, oh, that'd be a great idea. Let's do that. And then we never do it.
Yeah.
What made you take that leap to actually create something that, you know, you thought of while you were stoned and you were like, hey, that's a great idea, and I'm actually gonna do it.
I think I'm buying it too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome. I love to write. I've always loved to write, and I was trying to think of like a new writing project, and I was like, this is it. This is what I'm gonna do.
That's awesome. So we talk a lot of politics and activism here. Can we ask you some, just because you're not generally like someone that I would see at like a MassCan meeting, for instance, or involved in a lot of the activism that I, you know, that we've done locally. But I'd love to ask, kind of poll you on some like general politicians running for office and different organizations. And you can just give us, Danny, like a one-word answer. You can say, I don't know. I don't know enough about them. Whatever answer you want. Okay. And everything's cool. All right. Everything's cool here, right, Heather?
Yeah, pretty much.
Are like opposite sides and we get along.
Opposites attract, and you know.
Yeah, I love Heather Mack. haven't even commented on what you're wearing today. Are you like your hair?
My hair's dyed. Yeah, I'm wearing red for the Redline Bar Crawl.
I love your shoes.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, girls. I love your everything. We'll talk later.
We'll go back to politics. All right, for Danny.
Yeah, seriously.
We'll close out this segment with this little political quiz. Now I'm putting up the stakes. And we'll ask other people too in the room if they want to weigh in. We got Red Blazer just showed up, the big dog.
Yeah, wearing a relief.
Wearing a relief shirt. He's been supporting big on our show. Thank you, Glenn.
Yep. Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. How are you guys doing?
We're doing awesome. And we got Spencer doing video. Yeah. So if you guys want to weigh in too, and even Rob behind the board, if you want to weigh in on any of this, you let us know. So first we'll start with how about Ron Paul?
I have mixed feelings about Ron Paul. I would never vote for Ron Paul, but I think he has good ideas, and I think his ideas are different from what the Republicans and the Democrats are saying. And I think that when you have more people saying different things, it's good. It definitely makes you think.
All right. Anyone else who could get any comment on Ron Paul? Me and Heather have said it a million times, right?
I thought you were saying to go on to the next.
We'll go on to the next. How about, do you want to throw in some? Because you know y'all the ones probably coming from me. And do you have any?
Barack Obama. What do you have to say about it?
I like that he repealed DOMA, and the Democrats are trying to legalize same-sex marriage. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Right on.
But yeah. I do think that maybe he could be doing more. I feel like that's politicians, and I feel like politicians could always be doing more.
Mitt Romney.
No. I think no. If Mitt Romney gets into office, I'm
good answer. How about Gary Johnson?
I don't know who that is.
Oh, how about Jill Stein?
I've heard of Jill Stein.
Okay.
Elizabeth Warren.
I like her. I like her more than Scott Brown. I'd vote for her.
Opposite of me and everything.
What?
Almost. Well, how about medical marijuana? Question 3. Not opposite of me.
Not at all. I don't. No. No, I'm kidding.
Yes. You see a big yes. She's not opposite of me on that. What else? What do we got more? Don't we?
Sure.
What do we have?
Well, I
how about mass care normal?
I was about to say, yeah.
Yeah. Mass care normal?
Absolutely.
You like them?
Is that pro? That's pro.
Well, they're do you know a lot about them?
No, not really.
Okay. How about normal themselves, like National Organization of Reform of Marijuana Laws?
I think anyone who wants to go out there and try to activist for it and legalize it is awesome.
All right. And we must have more, don't we? How about I'm laughing.
You said I'm opposite you. Are you pro Romney?
He's pro. No, he's pro Ron Paul.
Gary Johnson.
Ron I'm very anti-liberal. Okay. Yeah, libertarians. In general. Okay.
You're with her.
That's
you're on her side of the
okay. Libertarians,
you're,
how do you feel?
You're a progressive.
Libertarians, how do you feel?
Yeah.
That's like Ron Paul, right?
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
I mean, I do believe in some things that they want, like small government. I totally believe in that. But yeah, I don't know if I'm believing everything Ron Paul says.
Okay. Well, I don't either. I'm not saying I agree with everything Ron Paul says either. But
can we ask about the other ballot initiatives? They're activist related, right?
That's what I'm talking about, yeah.
Okay. What do you think about death with dignity? That's question 2 this year, right?
That's like euthanasia.
Yep.
I think if you want to die, you should have the right to die. If you're in that much pain and no one should be keeping you alive if you don't want to.
Well, the right to repair.
That's so much less exciting.
That's about automotive cars.
What about full legalization on the public policy questions all across Massachusetts?
I'm all for that.
Right on. What got you into that originally? What got you into deciding that the marijuana laws were wrong and that you wanted to change them?
I just when I grew up, I was always told, I grew up in Rhode Island, I was told, like, weed was bad, it's terrible, and then I went to college, and I smoked it, and I was like, this isn't terrible at all. And there was a point where I would have really, really bad, like, migraines, and I would have to, like, call out of work, and, like, I found that smoking weed would really help me, and really, like, let me, like, be able to go to work and make a living and, like, pay my bills, and, like, I do that there are a lot of medical benefits to it, and
definitely
I don't understand, and half the time people are like, you're high, like I couldn't even tell, and I was just like, so why is it such a bad
exactly
thing?
Yep, I agree with that 100%.
Yeah, so I don't understand when people are against it. I feel like they've never tried it, and I feel like if they had, like, they would understand, whether or not they choose if it's right for them, they'd understand that, like, oh well, this isn't like this big bad thing that we are making it out to be.
There's a lot of misconceptions, and they're constantly being propagated by the No On Question 3 campaign, actually, which we're going to get into later. But they've been saying some really fun little lies on their website, on the other website. And it was so lovely having you, Danny, here on the show. I'm so excited to read your comic book. And one more time, where can we find it? What's the easiest way to find your stuff?
Look it up on Amazon Kindle. And Under the Surprise by Danny Marie and Jessica Vitale.
Nice. All right. Fantastic. What an awesome idea. I've been gaining my superpowers.
We really
want to
be in this next one. We want to be in the next one.
Yeah, I know. Seriously.
What do we have to do?
Like, I'm serious.
Do we have to have super, like, does that have to be established, like we talked about? Like, we have to have fire or something? Just be us? Like, how does that work?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. We'll work it out. Yeah, we'll work it out.
We'll work it out. All right. We'll work it out.
Creative minds.
We'll get creative minds going. Yeah,
exactly. We'll get this.
We'll figure it out. So, Two Hotheads Where Activism Happens, 617-606-4122. We're going to take a break. We're going to play some music. We're way over schedule. What do we have for music coming up? Big Dog over there.
You got The Doors.
Oh, wow.
All right. Okay.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, hell yeah. Thank you to Danny, to Red Blazer.
Yeah, Danny's got
to
run out.
To Rob
You have to go to work now, right?
Yeah.
She has to work her day job now. So thank you so much for coming in and taking the time.
Wonderful.
It was really great. I really learned a lot about, like, pro marijuana issues that will definitely help me in my comic book.
Great, and can you remind people where to find you?
You can find me on Amazon Kindle if you check under The Super Highs by Danny Marie and Jessica Vitale.
Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we had a great show this week. We had, we had Ben Stein from the UMass CRC called in. We had our girl, Danny, with her comic book, The Super Highs. I got a little super high. and why are you doing this to me? I can't. Don't do it. Turn it off. Turn it off. I can't do it.
Cut.
Two Hotheads Where Activism Happens, only on UnregularRadio.com.